For you to come, and thank you for the organizers for picking this topic. So I will discuss the treatment of non-small cell lung cancer, the state of the art and beyond, specifically focusing on the systemic therapies for advanced disease. Those are my disclosures. And before I start to discuss the systemic therapies, I just want to go through very quickly about what are the main milestones that have been achieved recently more. So this is always what happens. This can be managed without chemo at the first line. Only pembrolizumab every 3 weeks, not many side effects, with a very nice responses. If the patient do have a driver mutation, and it's not only EGFR, it should be screened for ALK and ROS1, which has been approved. Thank you. slower to diagnose a driver mutation. And this is actually a big mistake because many of the patients are
at this time. So my job today is address whether the distinction between PH associated to lung disease or pulmonary arterial hypertension. And these are, despite of that, the patient keep complaining of dyspnea, functional class 3-4, and he was limitation or little bit get better, so the cardiac index had finally he died. So I think this case illustrates that who had high values of pulmonary artery had very reduced value. But if you categorize them when they are candidates to or before
Thank you for the introduction. Good morning, everybody. So it's my real pleasure to be there. It's really important in nutritional epidemiology. It's really how to address, you know, the main risk factor in the predominant in the developed world is cigarette smoking. But many smokers do not develop this about the role of diet in disease prevention. And over the Greek diet had the highest content of olive oil and was also really high in fruit. The Dalmatian diet was really high in fish, and the Italian diet was really high in vegetable. So in line with their diet, this educational video is provided to you by the European Respiratory Society. It demonstrates how to perform flexible bronchoscopy. This is a valuable procedure that can be performed in an endoscopy suite and provides us with the ability to examine the airways. It can be used for either On the day of the examination, patients should avoid any type of meal for at least 6 to 8 hours before the procedure. It is preferred that they are accompanied by a friend or family member, and they are advised not to drive or handle any type of heavy equipment for the rest of the day following the procedure. Possible benefits and potential risks of the procedure. Lidocaine is also applied via the bronchoscope working channel in a spray-as-you-go delivery manner with a 1% solution. A good topical anesthesia can decrease sedation requirements. Before starting the bronchoscopy, all members of the medical team should revisit the case, the indication, the patient should lie in an upright position, the head is comfortably set on a pillow. The patient is connected to the monitor